Gonna have to. You streaming?
Just getting it sorted out now. YouTube.
I should be able to get to it from your subscriber.
What's on YouTube? I think the
I should be able to get to it from your subscriber.
It's changing every time. The link.
No, the video link, yes. But I should be able to get to your live stream from your page. Because you were able to do that link, yes. But I should be able to get to your live stream from your page. Because you were able to do that
link months, days old, right?
I should be able to get to your live stream from your page.
Let me try view as you were able to.
No. You've got it turned off somehow, I guess, that I can't see. You don't have it configured to show live stream on your front page?
I probably need to have a look at the channel, make sure the channel's working and stuff. Might be something to do with that custom URL. Because if the custom, if the URL is always the same, you're probably going to have the same link for it. It's generating different video.
Well, the video link's different every time. What I'm saying is I think you might have it where you need to check a box that says show on my subscriber page, right. My live streams. You may have it private. You have public?
I think sure it's public. I've clicked some to public. I'll have to go through the settings again.
Okay.
But
I can go directly to your video here, but.
I've got it into YouTube, so you can just click on that.
Me neither. I just know you checked on a bunch of things probably. So. Mm-hmm.
So
there's probably a checkbox somewhere that'll fix it.
Yeah, more than likely.
And get your stinking armies out of here, rats.
Yeah.
I know what they want.
What do they want?
I want to try to take this town.
So this is where Yeezus saves to best advantage. If you know that you want a particular settlement to finish off the province, so you've got all three or four, whatever how big the province is, get your armies into position, and if you see that an enemy or an ally, the ally is the worst thing, because you don't want to have to declare war on the ally to get that province. So get your use your saves, and you might have to go back and redo some battles, but at least then you've got an idea of how early you have to get your armies moving in order to capture that key point. Because that would bug the fuck out of me, here, so that Skaven's got one of your provinces in the middle of your territory that's stopping you from having the whole province to yourself. So this is what I would have gone back and used an army to besiege a town to stop them from getting it, get another army, besiege that town, hold it, and then get my reinforcements up to finish off taking the town, so I've got the province to myself. I had to do that because the Toon Kings were coming up and finishing off a lot of the dwarfs, and I was determined to get the main province of the dwarfs in the mountains, because it was like close to my territory, and I had to go back 4 turns to get my armies moving quickly enough to take control or besiege the province before the two kings arrived. I went back 4 freaking turns and got everything moving, and it was on the fourth move that they would have taken it. I went back 4, and within freaking 1 turn, they were back. They were up there. They must have had another army. They decided to go. So it was another race. I was like, I had to go cap this one, cap that one, and then leave this other one, and hopefully they didn't take that one, the last one. And I had to finish off that one, and then jump ahead of the Toon Kings. It was fucking annoying because they weren't there for like the first 3 turns. I didn't see them for the first 3 turns. I went back 4. Second turn in, they were fucking there. Just about to take the fucking town. I was like, oh, for fuck's sake.
So Tomb Kings have an ability that they can go hidden. They go underground. So you know how kind of Egypt type movies where they crumbled into the ground kind of thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, they can go hidden where you cannot see them. They're replenishing their troops.
Ah. Right,
I've used it before because I'm like, I'm on enemy territory and I can't replenish. Nope. I can go underground and I can replenish.
That's useful.
It's a stance.
That's a useful.
Yeah, if you look at my screen, it's this. Whoops. Killed it. Oh. Yeah. Well, I can stop streaming then.
Okay. next time.
But anyway, it's just a stance I was going to show you.
Yeah.
Let me get 20. What is that anyway? We'll attack him next round. Video looks so much better. 1080p, 1080 60p.
Well, I'm on.
Yeah, just in general. Oh, he came out to fight me.
Ah.
Withdraw.
What is the?
Damn it! I don't have my. I gotta reload. I got too close.
What is the bar? What was your chance of defeating him? 50-50 or less?
No, it was way less.
Oh, yeah.
I need my support.
Mm-hmm.
I approached him too close. My support was too far behind. So he jumped at that. Because he could get back into his town after killing me.
Right now, I'm past that now.
Fuck's sake.
Attack! Wipe them out! All die! Destruction!
Let's have a battle to start off with, shall we?
I gotta load one more turn. By the way, there's an autosave feature that can increment its checkbox. You'll get a save every turn, so you don't have to do it.
Right.
Yep, incremental autosaves. You'll just get a save every turn. Very nice.
The problem is that is if you do the turn and you need to go back 2-3 turns and you haven't saved.
No, you need to do your own if you want to branch. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying you can get an automatic one so you don't have to think about it. If all you want to do is go backwards sometimes.
Yeah,
which, like there, I do.
I've got the autosave.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, it autosaves as well. This is one of the first proper battles I've had with the top end gear. These fuckers ain't got no chance.
I usually don't fight things that are this easy.
I just wanted to have a look at the troops and say how they hold up. Because I've got the new Templar Knights in there, and I've got the spearmen, and I just want to get a more general idea on how they perform. Also me Templar cavalry as well. It's gonna go on 7.
Bastard.
I've also got some more spells. On the general, so I wanted to have a look at. With the big battles that are like, oh my god, I could lose this. You don't go and view right down on the battlefield because I'm too busy organising shit to just let it play. These kind of easy battles, you can actually get right into the action. Have a
right.
Look. There's supposed to be a waypoint freaking thing you could use. Ah, there it is. Ah, sweet. Left shift gives you the opportunity to put waypoints in.
Yep.
You can.
For your cavalry.
Yeah. Forgot all about that.
Also, you know, Alt allows you to select a group. Like move them, and Control will allow you to turn them.
Yeah.
Very nice to use.
Where is he doing?
Rather than using cursor key. Fuck's sake. Much better. This way, you gotta fight two armies to come out.
He's got three guns, two archers or crossbowmen, so I'm gonna have to take them out.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that battle, holy crap.
Let's have ya!
Yeah, Loco was like, you know, fight every battle, even the easy ones, so you can save as many troops as possible.
Oh, I just walked up half my troops with that. Oh my god. That is powerful. Holy shit. Just nearly wiped out a whole fucking regiment of my troops then, with
their troops or your troops?
Mine! Jesus Christ! That was a bad idea, but damn, that's powerful.
Oh, some of the spells?
Yeah.
Alright, my level 38 Necrotech is back.
That's good.
He wants an air, don't he?
Follow me.
I should have been.
I am bloody impressed with that freaking spell, that son of...
Now you know there's friendly fire with it. I need to check some of mine.
Jesus Christ, that I don't... It was like 100, yeah, and I wiped it down to 24 freaking soldiers left in that army. Crazily good. I'll tell you, that's when that starts off, I'm going to charge the big freaking general forward and hit him with that, because that's going to wipe out a good chunk of his decent troops if I can get him. Holy crap, that was good. Still there.
These lands are mine.
Here you go. I'm gonna chop it on this general. What's this?
Okay, I'm watching.
Well, you missed him. Just about missed him. Fuck. You dived out of the way of it, cheeky bugger. 30 seconds.
Weak. Witness true power.
Trying to suck the life out of him. That's crazily good. There we are. I've got all my treats back. The replenishment thing completely replenished all my army.
That's another spell?
No, it's a thing, because, you know, being it's like the undead, and you kill a load of their enemy, you can raise them and replace your army. It's like a troop replenishment bonus. I've just replaced all my army. All the troops that I lost, they've got instantly replaced.
Very nice.
Oh! That thing's on double now. I've just upgraded it. Holy shit, that's going to be good. Winds of Magic plus 15, so that's plus 15 start as well. Oh dear, they are, whoever attacks my main general, they are getting a fucking licking now.
Destroy them!
Mine!
Yes.
Weapon strength 140. Jesus Christ. Charge bonus 22. Mass resurrection. Interesting. Just still not too sure if that's what we're going for. Just not too sure if there's any engines.
Great.
Yeah. What the bloody hell? He's leveled up again. Still can't get a fucking rifle battalion. It's just fucking annoying. Just gonna capture this one now, and then the whole province is mine in the centre. Province secured. Good. What is it?
My bloodline calls.
Well, at least we can count just there.
Come, impress me.
Let's see. Can we change the thing to plus four? That's right. Let's go all the way over there to the bottom right hand corner, shall we? Or bottom left hand corner, shall we? Fucking stupid bloody thing. Right, let's put the provinces up to 16. Should be able to get a little bit more cash out of them. Is it the other one province? It's mine. Not supposed to be on. Yeah.
Yep, that's me. That you're looking at. Well, it was.
Yeah. Tomb Kings.
Tomb Kings. And actually my faction.
Well, my... I think he's going up and up, so... And I still can't trade with them, that's bullshit. Right from the capital can't be established, bullshit. That's got to do with fucking Vlad being in the way. It's Vlad's cutting through my territory. How many territories have you got left anyway? Improving. Hopefully be able to improve that enough to get him to join my tribe, because that'd be perfect now if he can join. And again, he's going to get wiped out against the Empire anyway, because the Empire's not going to be unless the Empire comes across my territory, I think he's safe. It's my territory there.
Your reliability is very low. Broken a lot of treaties.
Yep. Well, it's the fuck the trying.
Not gonna lie, I have.
They're trying to freaking drag me into freaking war. And well, do you think I'm just going to go into war when you tell me to, when I'm not exactly in the position to go to war? And he's like, then my reliability is low. What about your reliability? What about your reliability to me? Turn around asking me to join.
They needed your help. Let them down.
Really? Yeah. To let me down for asking me to join a freaking war that I didn't want to get in part of. So, no.
Where would we be today if America had that added?
Hmm.
You're like, I got nothing. You'd be speaking Deutsch.
No, I think we would have been wiped out if it, because we wouldn't have surrendered anyway. So.
Master of Unlife.
Well, the Denzians of that island would be speaking. Actually, they. There's no way for Nazis to win.
Well, I don't. Didn't have enough. They they wouldn't have been able to get over here now because we still had air superiority. We won the Battle of Britain. We stopped their Luftwaffe dead in the tracks. And we know from several attempts of people trying to get onto England, crossing the channel. It might be a small strip of water, but it's not easy. And they wouldn't have gotten over it.
But, yeah, it's defendable for sure.
Yeah, so it's and we're an ocean-going people. We've got the Royal Navy, and we've been seafaring for hundreds of years before America was even a colony. We've ruled the waves, so we knew how to fight on the ocean. We took out their main battleship, Bismarck and the Tirpitz. So
take out their submarines.
No, but we would have better. Would have just fucking death charged them into a submission anyway. But they wouldn't have gotten onto England. The other thing they might have.
They didn't have enough people. No doubt, Germans didn't have enough.
If the war dragged on without the American assistance, we might have gotten wiped out by nuclear bomb, because they know they're already manufacturing heavy water.
So, yeah. They would have dropped some big bombs.
Mm-hmm.
And we didn't have much impact up there anyway. Ours was all Japan.
You definitely have out on D-Day. You got a few battalions on the beaches. You got the American 101st Airborne dropping in just before D-Day. So you definitely.
Yeah, MacArthur was up there.
But
had no Navy support.
No, because let's say. We've had that covered anyway, so.
Right. Hit it. God dang. Words are insane.
What's going on with the bloody ants? Because they're sitting there, taking 600 fucking.
So his armies are just going to stay there.
It's not allied with anybody. Who's he attacking now? Two kings have taken over the freaking map.
Yep. They have an easy go of it somewhat because they don't have upkeep. I got a third support army coming in to help that dwarf town.
Really? Freaking small army like that's trying to besiege my town. Ballsy.
Is that even? I just saw it. It's like
three freaking troops. That's it.
I hunt.
Bit aggressive, isn't it?
Oh, I should have taken the top nuts. Skaven took that town. Oh. Well, no, they're just a bag of money. They don't have it.
Yeah, plus 19 now on the happy days.
God, they still don't think I can do it. Shit.
it at night. Citra does not marvel at my pyramid, nor that you will never achieve such majesty.
The Empire.
Honor before glory.
I am the blood of Gilles.
Well, he's got two there, so the rest of his provinces. And this one.
Wow, Britannia. It's a lot.
Yeah.
It only says
Protector
four.
Of the realm.
Oh, you're looking at somebody else.
Yeah. What? That might be an option to... No, I've got a fucking non-aggression pack. God damn it.
Dark are these times. Dark, my mood.
Undead Apollonium.
The treaty with them, then now. Three provinces. And the Wood Elf Realms. Okay, they've got a fair few turns on us there. Well, hopefully, a rebel army will take that province and I'll be able to take that Shadar away.
Won't take it?
He's just took that off Vlad, and he's on minus 19%. Public order. And it's that's per turn. He's already on minus 41. So if that keeps going up and up and up, there will be a rebel army spawning there eventually. And then as soon as it, hopefully if it takes the town, I can just walk in and take the town without being going to war.
Oh, I get you.
It's just little bits and ways of getting around the problems like that. I'm on that one settlement, but I don't particularly want to go to war with it for it just yet. Let's have an army on standby, just in case. I want to get a better relationship with the Toon Kings, want a defensive alliance with them before I attack these buggers here, because I think they're allied with them.
Don't mess with me! What's your message?
Yeah, military alliance. We've got a military alliance with the Toon Kings, so if I attack them, I'm going to piss off the Toon Kings.
So don't do that.
Yeah.
Because we'll get you.
Starts disbanding some of these shit troops and then filtering around. You stupid little shit.
This suits my cause.
isn't it?
Helmengorst.
Knots as well.
Ready.
All right, one more turn. That army's powered up. Castle Draken.
Oh, I do like it when I've got a little bit of time to myself and not having to attack. I've got no wars currently.
None.
Nope. Not a war raid over there at the moment. Such as my diplomatic skills and not pissing anybody off. I've taken up some of the loan settlements. This is where I'm going to start probing for easy targets. Might have to break in an aggression pack with these fuckers. I can take these out with the lightning strike, get me troops in position. Two armies on each border of their settlements, and then declare war, and they'll be wiped out fucking quick because they've got any alliances. The next few 20 odd turns, I'm going to be saving cash and getting the armies into position and building up what I can on the main provinces. Get everything to max. Get all the town halls and castles up to max. And then put garrisons in where I can. Send the agents out to scout round, see if anybody else is ripe for conquest.
Yeah. Who to take out first, right?
Well, yeah, this is the main thing. You probe. You use your agents to find out who's been in, who's at war, and if we can join that war and take an easy province here and there, and if there's any places of strategic value with mines and other stuff and tradable items, and just got a probe, have a look at what's going on the map, and so you stay away from the big wars that you don't want to get dragged into, unless you're really prepared, because I don't want to take out the Empire or the Two Kings or take them on just yet until I'm got a sufficient amount of army and more defensive, and I know where their armies are and what the strengths are and where the weaknesses are.
Yeah.
It's like chess. You got to think 10, 15, 20 moves ahead. Fashion encounter. Dune Kingdoms.
Screwed. What is?
got rid of a load of the troops that I didn't need, because I'm not in battle with anybody, and so I've got 9,516 coming in.
My
a couple of those I can probably
no
get up
limits.
To 10 grand. Do I keep the black coach?
You're the red on the map, right?
What?
Yeah, are you the blue or the red?
Red. That's
when it comes to war with the Tomb Kings.
I've got some moves for them. He's minus 16. No, minus 60. That is going to have an army swarm. Guaranteed. In the next couple of turns, that's gonna have a freaking. That's gonna have a. That's gonna have a rebel army. I hope it fucking takes the town. I want that town. That is my province.
Hovers close to my blade. Utter your demand before I raise it.
I'll raise it in your ass.
Yes.
He's got a military alliance with the fucking Empire. Right.
Yep, they know what they're doing.
This action does not have my consent.
This is proven. Might be able to get a trade deal out of him. Trade with Vlad. Yeah. Trade with. Got a treaty with the Shadow Warriors. Do I? Yes, I do.
Dalskirneth! Quare works of Yath!
Cancel military alliance. going to take me up to 105 of them, so... Great power.
I has powers. Yous don't want to go in my head, vampire.
Cancel military access.
Holy crap! I've got a 269 with the Skaven.
What?
My diplomacy is 269 with the Skaven.
Yeah, the military alliance, you get up there quite quick.
Toon King of Nehekara.
Wonder if I could do something like... They still won't do a vassal, but you have to outpower them, I think.
Mm-hmm.
When you make them that, do they... It won't match your towns, right? Won't get a province?
It's a joint confederation.
That's the one that... Okay. Shit. All right, I starved the dwarfs out a turn. Now it says.
It is night.
Fool.
has to create a fucking army quick then.
So... Friends of the Empire, come. A weak order.
Better be important.
The Empire.
Alrighty, more door.
Hmm?
No more dwarfs.
Hey.
Hold on.
Is that the same clan that gave me problems, or is it a different, different clan?
Nope, same clan. He only had one town left.
Right.
No, they are no more.
You could say you've cut them down to size.
Some stone gatherers come from their mountain holes to plead for mercy.
Military alliance. Interesting. Who are you at war with? You pissed off anybody? Oh dear. You're at war with him. You're gonna die, and you're not taking me with you. Money's raking in now. I'm on to 11,140 money coming in.
Nice.
Sylvania's borders. We will raid the tombs. Who wishes the red kiss?
This is a good stopping point for me. You gonna be up late, or you gonna?
Yeah, I'll be up for a while. Go to bed. Well, I'm good up, actually.
Alright. I'm gonna be a few hours, so I'm gonna do a lot of running errands and stuff.
Okay. See you back. Alright,
well, yak. Yep. Yak you later.
See you in a bit.